Hello everyone, I hope you're well. Today, we're talking about entertainment law. So whenever I meet people who aren't super familiar with what lawyers do or just aren't familiar with, I guess, non-traditional types of law, and I tell them that I am a lawyer for creatives, I always get asked, what is that? What do you actually do? I've never heard of that. And so I thought it would be interesting to break down what I do into various videos, and we're going to start today with entertainment law. I'm going to be going through what entertainment law actually is, the different jobs you can have as an entertainment lawyer, what an entertainment lawyer actually does, classes you should be looking into if you're interested in entertainment law, and various resources on the topic that I will be linking to in the description down below. If it's your first time here, hi, my name's Aisha. I am a lawyer and entrepreneur based in Montreal, Canada, and I make videos about becoming a lawyer, law school productivity, legal information, and a bunch of other topics. All right, so let's start with the basics. What is entertainment law? Entertainment law encompasses various areas of the law that impact the entertainment industry. Lawyers who work in entertainment law deal with contracts, intellectual property, mostly copyright and trademarks, labor law, corporate law, sometimes immigration law, advertising law, insurance law, and honestly, the list goes on. To put it simply, think about any form of entertainment that someone would like to put out there and the different steps that they have to go through in order to be able to put out that content. So for instance, let's say that I have a client who wants to start a small record label. At the very beginning of that label's life, knowledge of corporate law is going to be needed in order to create the structure in which the record label is going to function. Some knowledge of trademark law is going to be useful in order to make sure that the label's name or the label's logos aren't problematic. The label is, of course, going to need contracts between the founders, contracts with their artists, contracts with their employees. And through that, different areas of the law are going to be involved. So for instance, for the contracts with the employees, you're gonna need some knowledge of labor law. For the contracts with the artists that the label wants to sign, you're gonna wanna know quite a bit about copyright law, whether that would be for publishing agreements or just a standard production agreement. Maybe the client is going to have some questions about what he can do in terms of advertisement. So as you can see, knowledge of various areas and the law is going to be required at different points in that record label's life. Now that you know what entertainment law is, where can you work as an entertainment lawyer? The entertainment industry is typically split into multiple subcategories. So you can work in the music industry, you can work in the film industry, you can work in theater, you can work in book publishing, you can work with comedians, you can work in TV, and a bunch of other categories. And within these categories, you can work at various places. The jobs that you can have are typically going to be split into two categories. So you're going to have your jobs at a law firm, or you're going to be working in the legal department of a company or an organization. And when it comes to being an in-house counsel, there are tons of opportunities out there. So for instance, you can work for a producer either in TV or in the film industry. You can work for a record label. You can work for a TV broadcaster. If you like books, you can work in a publishing house. If you're really interested in the labor law side of things, then you can work in-house for associations, whether that be a music publishing association, an author association. You can work at an agency. And once again, if you work at an agency, you can work in the music industry, you can work with comedians, the list goes on, and advise agents and their clients. You can work for a circus like Cirque du Soleil here in Montreal. And mind you, everything that I just mentioned, you can also do at a law firm. The only difference is that instead of having one client, which is the company or the organization that you'll be working for, you're going to have multiple clients. And you also have to keep in mind that organizations who have in-house counsel also sometimes require external counsel. So just because you aren't employed at Cirque du Soleil doesn't mean that you're not going to have Cirque du Soleil as a client if you work at a law firm. On a day-to-day basis, what does an entertainment lawyer actually do? To answer this question, I'm going to give you some insight into what my workload looks like. I personally work mostly in the music industry, but I do have clients in the book publishing industry. I do have clients that are comedians. I do have clients in the film industry. I personally do not do any litigation, which means that I don't go to court. So of course, the type of work that I do is going to be different from an entertainment lawyer who actually does go to court. But the type of work that I do consists of reading contracts, drafting contracts, reviewing contracts, and giving legal advice to my clients, as well, of course, as negotiating agreements. contracts. For instance, right now I'm in the process of drafting a contract for a client of mine who wants to make a movie that is based on a book that already exists. And so in order to get funding, he needs to prove that he actually has the rights to adapt the book. So I am currently drafting an option agreement for him. I'm also currently negotiating a licensing agreement for a client of mine who is a small record label. I drafted the initial, like, standard agreement that they're going to use with all of their artists. And now I'm negotiating the term of that agreement with a specific artist that they're looking to sign at the moment. I also recently finished reviewing a 360 deal for a client of mine who is in the music industry. A 360 deal is when a label gets revenue from multiple streams of revenue. So the types of revenue are going to depend on the contract, but typically we're talking about revenue from production, revenue from licensing, revenue from merchandising, touring, etc. I also review a lot of management agreements. Usually, a lot of my clients, when they come to see me for the first time, they come to see me when they're just about to sign a management agreement with their new manager. And so I need to go through everything just to make sure that they're not getting screwed in the deal. I've also had to do really interesting things for my clients, like look into PR firms for them, go through content that they've created to make sure that nothing in the content is problematic. But the gist of the work really for me is drafting, reviewing, and reading. So if you're interested in entertainment law, what classes should you be looking into? Obviously, all law schools are different. All law schools offer different classes. But to give you general guidelines as to what you should be looking into, I'd say IP classes, intellectual property classes, are pretty crucial. At UDM, at Université de Montréal, which is where I studied law, we had a copyright law and music class, which was absolutely fascinating. So if you have something along those lines, definitely take it. But really, any copyright or trademark law class is going to be extremely useful in entertainment law. Contract law classes are also a must. If you have classes where you can actually draft contracts, that is awesome. Obviously, if your law school offers entertainment law courses, just take them. Also, any media law classes are super handy. I remember at UDM, we had this class that was called Information and Communication Law. I loved it. I still use everything that I learned in it today. And then if you want to get really specific, you can look into labor law classes, you can look into insurance law classes. And if you're able to take classes that aren't law related, then I would definitely say a good public relations class can be very handy. I've seen what can happen when a lawyer gives legal advice, pretty decent legal advice, but without having any knowledge of public relations in, you know, very public cases, and that can be an absolute mess. So if that is something that is available to you, just go for it. And now, resources that you should be looking into if you're interested in entertainment law. I would say, first things first, staying updated on current events is really essential. I personally read The Hollywood Reporter. I really like reading Deadline. I also subscribe to the What I Hear newsletter. It's a newsletter by Matt Baloney, who used to be an editor at The Hollywood Reporter and who also happens to be an entertainment lawyer. I also subscribe to Trapital, which is a hip-hop business newsletter. And that one is by Dan Runcie. And Dan Runcie also has a really interesting podcast that you can look into. And speaking of podcasts, the Denton's Entertainment Law podcast is really interesting. Of course, I will link to everything that I talk about in this video in the description down below. If your local newspaper has an art section, I would say read that frequently. I personally read La Presse and Le Devoir here in Quebec. I will also be linking to a few books that you will be referring to for your entire career if you go into entertainment law. I'll be linking to some Canadian books as well as some American books. The one that I personally refer to the most is a music law book by Paul Sanderson. I have it right here. It's called Musicians and the Law in Canada. I used to borrow this book all the time at the library, and I figured at one point I should just buy it. So I did. Great book. And that's it for this video. If you guys have any questions about entertainment law or what an entertainment lawyer actually does, please do not hesitate to leave them in the comments down below. If you like this video, do not hesitate to give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and I will be seeing you very soon. Bye guys!